Hello and welcome to the 48th and final video in this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how to export out a video presentation ready to share in After Effects. So, in the previous video, we completed the last section of the video presentation by adding the final animation details to our city scene. Once we have finished our video presentation, it is now time to export ready to share. In this video, I'll be showing you how to wrap up your video project, export it off ready to share, and I'll give you some good pointers on where you can go next after this course to continue your learning and build on top of everything we have learned on this course. So let's get into it. So here I am where we left off in the previous episode, where we completed the video presentation. Now, if you're watching for the first time and wish to follow along, you can find this document in the project folder, which you can download. Link is in the description. The download folder comes with lots of exercise documents we will be using on this course that have been carefully developed to aid your learning experience. The folder also comes with document resources such as videos, graphics, and images you can use to build your first video presentation from scratch later on in this course. To get the full learning experience, I recommend you get the project folder. Download link with instructions is in the description. With the project folder open, click into the S3 Create a Project folder, then click into folder 48, Exporting in After Effects, and open the Exporting a Video Presentation document. Now, if you are continuing on from the last episode, make sure you have your document open and ready. So with our document open, let's proceed. So now we have finished the presentation, we have a set duration. Right now, we can see that the main comp extends further than the actual presentation content. So the first thing I'm going to do is adjust the duration of this comp to fit the presentation nicely. So if I drag my time indicator while holding shift to snap to the end of section 7, I can see over on the far left of the timeline panel that the entire video presentation is about 1 minute and 9 seconds long. So what I'll do is come and click into this time value, select it and copy. Next, I'll press Command K on Mac or Control K on PC to pull up the composition settings. So right now, we can see this comp is set to 1 minute 20 seconds. So I'll come in here and paste in the time value I just copied and click OK. Upon click, it will now trim the comp to that time. Perfect. So with my comp complete, I can now export this off ready to share. However, before we do that, there are some quick checks we need to make. First is the resolution factor. Before we export, we need to make sure this is set to full. And next, we need to check the workspace area is spanning the entire duration of the comp. I can do this really easy by double-clicking on the workspace area, and this will snap to the entire duration of the comp. Next, we need to make sure that the audio layers are on so we can hear the audio. Right now, the audio is toggled off for my sections, but the audio is on for my background music track. That is all I want to hear. So once all the checks are done and I'm ready to export, I'll come up to position and click Add to Adobe Media Encoder. Upon click, we will see the media encoder load up. Now, for those of you using older versions of After Effects without media encoder, you will need to choose Add to Render Queue instead. So once media encoder loads, we should see an item in the list. This is our main comp ready to export. Now, if we select this row and hit the green play button at the top right, this will render the video straight away. But before that, we want to adjust some of the settings. So first, I'll click on the output file settings on the right, and this will bring up a browser window. Here, we can select where we will place the exported video, and I'll navigate to my project folder and click into the export folder and click save. So next, if I want to set a preset, I can click on the preset settings. Here, I'll go with H.264, as that's the good standard codec. And for the preset, I'll choose high quality 1080p HD. Now, there are a bunch of other settings, but right now, I'm not going to mess about with these. My preset and my format are just fine. So once happy, I'll click OK, and this will bring me back to the queue. Now, for those of you using older versions of After Effects, upon clicking Add to Render Queue, you will see the timeline change where you can specify your settings. Simply follow the previous steps as shown in the media encoder, but in the render queue instead, as the process is similar. Now back in media encoder, once I have specified the settings, I can hit the green play button. In older versions, you will hit the render button to the far right of the render queue panel. Upon click in Media Coder, the video will begin to render and we will see the progress as it happens down in the encoding panel below. Now, depending on your processing power, this could take anything from a few seconds to a few minutes. Once rendered in the Media Encoder or the render queue, I can then navigate to the project folder into my exports folder and I should see the video file there, which I can open with whatever video player I have on my computer. This video is now ready to upload to the internet and share over social media. So that's it. That's how you can create a video presentation in After Effects and export ready to share. In this series, we covered a lot of basic techniques to get you up to speed with the program and understand how everything works. Now, if you have enjoyed using After Effects and want to learn more, be sure to check out the What to Learn Next page in my PDF document that goes along with this course. On this page, I have some links and suggested content that you will find really beneficial to keep you learning more in this program. On this page, you will find some links to some topics I did not cover on this course, so be sure to check this out. So that completes this beginner's guide to Adobe After Effects. What a journey! If you've been following along since the start, well done. I truly hope you have enjoyed this series. If you are not familiar with After Effects before this course, I hope I have helped you get up to speed with some of the basics to help you create your own projects in future. Now, if you like the course, please subscribe to the channel. There will be lots more content like this in future, so don't miss out on that. If you like the course, be sure to share it with your friends who also may be interested in learning After Effects. If you wish to hear more about up-and-coming video tutorials and general creative news and updates, you can follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and like the Facebook page. Well, that's it for another video course. My name is Gareth David. Have fun, guys, and I'll see you next time.